space radiation is a, it's a showstopper. It's a showstopper for future space travel, for long duration travel. I mean, we've, in the past, we've had short missions. If you do longer missions, the radiation dose that the astronaut would receive would be higher. I mean, radiation dose is accumulative. The longer you are there, the more radiation dose you get. And right now, for a long mission to go to Mars and back, we can't do it. So we've got to have better radiation shielding materials in order to do that. I'm looking at this experimentally and computationally. I'm trying to design a better radiation shielding material. The smaller the element, the better it is, the more effective it is for breaking up these larger particles. Now, why do we want to break them up? We can't stop them. So the next best thing we can do is break them up into smaller things that are less damaging and less hazardous. So I'm looking at light elements. In particular, I'm looking at hydrogen and boron and nitrogen because I think that we can get the most bang for the buck, if you will. One material ingredient that we're using, I guess we can call it an ingredient, is the boron nitride nanotubes. Boron nitride nanotubes are composed entirely of boron and nitrogen. Boron absorbs neutrons very effectively, and neutrons are one of the radiation species that we're trying to stop. And so the boron does a very good job of absorbing neutrons. Nitrogen does an okay job. And the two together, you know, do a really good job. The materials we're looking at are not only radiation shielding materials. They're materials that are structural materials that we could also use for building the vehicle, the habitat, the rover, the spacesuit. And then these same materials could be used on Earth, you know, for high altitude aircraft. They have a radiation problem. Pilots on high altitude aircraft, the Concorde, for example, they wore dosimeters. They were classified as radiation workers because they were flying in a radiation environment. It's down here on Earth, there's not, you know, that much, but at high altitude, there is quite a bit of radiation. Not as much as in space, but there's still enough radiation that if you are a frequent flyer or a crew on a high altitude airplane, you get a significant radiation dose. And so our materials could lend themselves to, you know, high altitude aircraft, that, you know, the structural part, and, you know, fabric applications also. We are excited to be given the opportunity to do something new and exciting, and this is very new, and we think it'll have a high payoff.